Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 14.0.1 has been out for quite a while at this point, as well as iOS 14.2 Beta 2. And so I wanted to cover a few new features in iOS 14.2 Beta 2, as well as go over the follow-up like I do every week based off the YouTube community poll. Now the first thing is, there is a major battery bug with iOS 14.0.1 and watchOS 7. So those particular bugs will drain your battery really fast, and Apple has actually acknowledged it and given us a fix, but it's not the best fix. Basically, what you need to do is completely wipe your device and start over again. So you would make a backup, wipe your device, and start over. That should clear out any bugs that you're having with it and should in turn result in better battery life. Hopefully, iOS 14.1 or 14.2 will fix this in the future, but that's their current suggestion, which I don't think is great, but that's what we have. Now, the first thing that's new with 14.2 Beta 2 that I didn't cover in my initial video is actually picture-in-picture on YouTube. YouTube has brought it back if you use Safari. So if you go into Safari, you'll see here's my Apple Watch SE unboxing. If I hit play, we'll just bring the volume down. If I make it full screen, swipe up. Now I've got it picture-in-picture on my device, and I can move it around, resize it, whatever I want. That's without signing in and without a subscription or anything. So that should work for you. They've brought it back, which was great. It doesn't yet work in the YouTube app. So hopefully we'll see that in the future, but we don't have it now. Now, the next thing is, in the Home app, they keep changing the icon for the Home. So this has been changed a couple times. This is the new icon with Beta 2, but they do keep changing it back and forth depending on which one you have. Now, also, thanks to my friend Steve Mosier at Mac Rumors, he actually found evidence of no AirPods in the, or EarPods rather, in the box of the iPhone 12. So not only are we not going to get a charger, it looks like we're not going to get EarPods either. Now, I know a lot of people have those, but a lot of people need an extra pair of EarPods because for some people, they just don't last that long. So unfortunately, we don't have those. It looks like we'll have to wait and see what Apple does once they release the phone. Now also, if you're using AirPods Pro with spatial audio, these are just AirPods 2, but if you have them connected and then you go into your settings, let me pair these quick. Once your AirPods Pro are paired, you want to go to settings and then you go down to accessibility. Under accessibility, you want to go down to audio/visual and you'll see mono audio. Once you tap on mono audio or turn on the switch, you'll get a new little dialogue at the bottom that says turning on mono audio will turn off spatial audio. Now as far as new features in iOS 14.2 Beta 2, that seems to be it, but there was one I didn't mention in a previous version with Beta 1. So if you triple click or you go to your magnifier app, go to magnifier, under magnifier, you'll now have a people option. Now, if you're not seeing the people option, hit the little settings here, and now you have people detection. And under people detection, you can judge the distance to people. So if there was someone over there, it would tell me how far away they are. So it's a really nice little option. If you want to use magnifier, maybe measure the distance between someone, it will tell you what that actually is. Now with iOS 14.2 Beta 2, there are definitely some bugs, especially if you use WhatsApp. So for example, if you're using WhatsApp, a lot of people are having issues with it crashing, having issues with audio and messages, as well as viewing videos in the app itself, as well as the camera not working. So all of these problems need to be addressed, and I think that's because the app does not comply probably with whatever updates Apple put in iOS 14.2. So there will need to be an update. Some people are having it on iOS 14.0.1 as well, but again, Facebook will need to update WhatsApp to make it compliant since they own that particular app. So hopefully we'll see that pretty soon, but that's the number one complaint I'm getting. Also, people who are using the clock app are having similar problems. So people are saying that the time is just not keeping up again, and that seems to be the case. You'll see I have mine set to Cupertino, which makes a difference, so it's not going to be the same time that you're seeing here, but it's definitely an issue that people are having. And then also when trying to add a new widget, people are seeing their widgets blink. So if we try and add a widget here, a lot of people are seeing these widgets blink over and over and over, and that seems to be a problem for a lot of people. So those are the major issues people are having with iOS 14.2 Beta 2, and hopefully they'll fix it in the future with Beta 3. However, battery life seems to be pretty decent for most people. Now, like I said, with iOS 14.0.1, battery life is hit or miss, depending on which one we're talking about, which phone. Most people that are having issues seem to be on iPhone 7 for some reason. But with iOS 14.2 Beta 2, most people are having really good battery life. or performance. Now, the people that are not having good battery life, generally, I think I've found an issue that one of my viewers mentioned to me over Twitter, and that has to do with handoff. It seems like handoff is using a lot of power. So I've been trying to mess around with this a little bit. And if you look for handoff, you can just find the setting by searching it. Go to AirPlay and handoff. And under handoff, if you turn it off, now it is a feature I use a lot, but if you don't have a Mac or an iPad, it makes no sense to have it turned on. But when you have it on, what it will do is maybe you're in Safari, it will pop up on your iPad or your Mac nearby so that you can continue reading where you left off. So it's very handy for certain things. I use it for notes a lot, but apparently it seems to be draining a lot of power. So hopefully they'll fix that in the future. I did notice that it seems to fix the issue. So for me, battery life, let's take a look at it before we talk about a couple other things and what you had to say. So if we go to battery life, battery health, you'll see my battery health is at 94%. It does go down. It's going to continue to go down. It's based off the actual physical capability that's remaining in the physical battery behind the phone. So that battery is going to degrade over time. It's just the nature of batteries. And I expect it to go down by 90% in a few more months. Now, Apple says 80% after 2 years is normal, so 94 is not too bad. Now, if we take a look at the last 10 days, since I turned off handoff yesterday, we'll see that I had 4 hours and 3 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 38 minutes of screen off time. That's using 50% of my battery life. So that's actually okay. It's not great. I'm expecting better battery life today. In fact, you'll see I've only used about 30% and I'm at 3 hours and 30 minutes and 2 hours and 6 minutes. So it's doing much better. So handoff does seem like it made a difference. So if you're having issues, keep that in mind. Now with iPadOS, I really haven't had any issues with it. It's been really smooth and I've been using it on iPadOS 14.0.1 because the beta gave me a charging issue with the first version, which does seem to be fixed with the second version. But just in general, I need my iPad to be fairly stable. So I do have it on an iPad Air 2, but on my iPad Pro, this is running the public version and it's super fast. I haven't had any issues. And let's just take a quick look at battery since I actually haven't looked at it since. We don't have battery health for this device, but over the last 10 days, you'll see that I don't charge it every day, but I'm using it for about an hour or so every single day with the screen on. And then there's some screen off time as well. Although I'm not sure what that is with this particular device since I don't use it like that, but you'll see I'm at 49% battery life right now. And there is no battery health, like I said, but the battery life here is 49% and it's holding up well. And I've used it for about 4 hours or so. So 10 hours is normal. It just depends what you're doing. You'll see 52% of my time is on YouTube. Now, most people were saying performance is really good. No issues with that. No issues going back and forth between apps, opening different apps, having them load. They seem to be pretty good. Scrolling and everything else seems to be decent. So most people are not having issues with that. And in fact, here's all of the issues that people were mentioning based off the YouTube community poll. And you can see WhatsApp was 14 different times it was mentioned. Battery was mentioned, usually for iOS 14.0.1 or people saying that it's better. But in general, it seems like those are the main concerns with these updates. Now here's all the devices people are using based off the community poll. And then also, we're still waiting for the next update. In fact, the other day, Apple stopped signing iOS 14. So what that means is there's probably an update imminent. So I would expect a new update this coming week, maybe Tuesday or Wednesday, where we'll see an iOS 14.1 or maybe 14.0.2, depending on what Apple does. It seems like you would see iOS 14.1 and then maybe an announcement for the Apple event where they're going to show off iPhone 12, because we've been waiting for that. We think that'll come out on the 6th of October, where they'll send out invites for maybe an event the following Tuesday, so or Monday. So let's wait and see what they do with that. But I think we're going to see an update this coming week, so expect that. However, I would not expect iOS 14.2 beta 3 unless Apple changes it, because I think we're on a 2-week cycle at this point. I wouldn't expect beta 3 for another week or so. So hopefully we have them for a couple weeks and we get that final release where things are a little bit more stable for a while, and then iOS 14.2 gets all the bugs worked out and then we're good to go. So hopefully that's what we see. Now let's take a look at the YouTube community poll. Now the community poll's been out a little while. It has 7.7k votes at this time, or 7,700 votes, and 17% of you are saying that it's great. 4% of you are saying it's terrible, 7% are saying okay, but some bugs, and 62% of you are still on iOS 14.0.1, and 10% of you are on an older version. If I go back one and we take a look at the 14.0.1 poll, 26,000 people voted, and only 5% said it was terrible out of the people that actually updated. So the number's a little bit higher if you do the math here, but basically only 50% of the people that voted said that it was great. So Apple definitely has some work to do on that. Now let's take a look at some of the comments. Mudith or Mudith said, had a terrible battery experience with iOS 14, so downgraded to 13.7 on my iPhone 11. Couldn't be happier, waiting for iOS 14.2 public release to jump ship. And it seems like you did it just in time, since Apple's no longer signing even iOS 14. So it must have been a couple weeks ago when you did that. Alistair said, only issue I'm still having is Wi-Fi and data connectivity. Thankfully, I haven't had an issue with that, but I have seen a couple others. Only about three people mentioned it, though. Alex Detmer said, I'm using an iPhone SE second generation, and I'm having a problem where my Bluetooth earbud is connected, but the icon in the top right isn't showing. Matthew A. said, iOS 14.2 Beta 2 on my 11 Pro Max. I've had no issues at all, and battery has been great, 11 plus hours. And that's what you should be expecting from an 11 Pro Max, 10 to 12 hours. Let's take a look at another one here. And Curtis Clark says, unable to view videos from WhatsApp. I'm using an iPhone 6S. T. Hayes says, so far it's awesome on my iPhone 7. Currently no issue for me to report. T. Weichel says, iPhone XR had some minor connectivity issues, and once the camera UI flickered until I took the photo. Also had a weird bug that when Siri replied to my request, like send a message to, her voice was dramatically slowed, and in the other parts of the UI, she sounded normal. Silverboy said, way better battery life on my iPhone XS Max. Favorite Tech X says, iPhone SE 2016, battery life better than iOS 14.0.1, and performance is great. Mike V says, I'll need to get on it if you want notifications during calls to work again. I've heard this from a couple people saying that calls, when you're making a phone call, you no longer hear any additional notifications. Personally, I would see that as a feature, but I guess there should be an option for it to turn it on or off. Chavez 1909 says, it seemed that the battery life greatly improved on my iPhone 10. And we'll read one more. It says, Vasil says, on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, iOS 14.2 Beta 2 is much better than iOS 14, much stable. Battery life is great. I like it. I hope the final version to be much better. Thumbs up, zollotech, for great videos. And thanks very much. And so that's it for iOS 14.2 Beta 2 and iOS 14.0.1. Like I said before, I think we'll see an update this coming week. So I'm looking forward to that, as well as invites from Apple to their next event. So of course, I'm looking forward to the event and iPhone 12. But let me know what you're looking most forward to in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.